Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be doing this look. Now I started off already with my base, so I've got my L'Oreal Base Magic Primer on, and then I followed that with my MAC Studio Fix Fluid Foundation, and then I used a combination of two different concealers. So I've got the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind and the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer under my eyes, and then I set all that with my Ben Nye Luxury Powder, and I used my Real Techniques sponge. Gosh, I can't talk. Alright, so first off, to start off with the eyes, we're going to use some sticky tape, and I'm going to take Tease from the Naked 2 palette and pop that in my crease just to kind of start it off. I'm then going to take Espresso and Mystery from MAC and deepen up that crease, make it nice and dark before we pop on those purples. I'm now taking Sketch on a fluffy brush and putting that in the crease as well. And just gonna blend it all and out and make it wonderful. I'm then putting some Fix Plus on a flat shader brush, and I'm taking this incredible pigment by Makeup Store called Vampire. It's one of their eye dusts and it's amazing. I'm just taking now a clean blending brush and I'm just kind of blending it all out, and I was freaking out there because of all the fallout. So I will be going in with concealer on afterwards. I'm taking a little bit more of Mystery, I think it is, and I'm just blending that in the crease again and darkening it up slowly. I'm taking now a tapered blending brush and I'm using Blackout from the Naked 2 palette. Blending it all out so it's nice and seamless. And that moment of truth when you take off the tape. So I'm putting now more of the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer under my eyes to brighten it up, because the tape did take a lot of makeup off. And just using my, I think it's the Sigma F86 brush to blend that all out. And then I just set it. And my eyebrow was looking a little bit naked, so I'm using my Hourglass Arch Brow in Soft Brunette now, filling them in. And then I'm going to go in with the Models Prefer Brow Kit in a moment, there we go, just to darken it up, because this look was quite fierce and I needed my brow game to be super strong in this one. And then taking this really light lilac shade from the Chi Chi Rich Gems palette, and I'm just going to use that in my inner corner to highlight. I'm then going to go back to that shader brush that we used before to pop the pigment all over my eyes, and I'm running that underneath my lash line and then blending it all out. And as you can see, I'm just kind of extending that line and blending it out a little bit more, because I wanted it to be a little bit more dramatic, and just blending it all out so that there's no harsh lines. And then going to do a nice medium-sized wing using a Dolly Wink eyeliner, which I bought when I was in Hong Kong. And then I'm going to tightline and put it on my waterline, but this is the Rimmel Black Kohl Pencil, and then smudging it all out with my Sigma Pencil Brush. And then taking a mix of Vanilla and Shroom from MAC and highlighting my brow bone with an angled brush. Popping on a few coats of mascara before I put on some falsies. This is the Maybelline Colossal Mascara. I'm using these lashes, which I got from a costume website, which I'll be telling you about in a little while. I'm using the Duo Lash Glue and popping them on my eyeballs. And then gonna contour like crazy. This is step one. On a big fluffy brush, I'm taking the contour color from the Sleek Contour palette in Light, and then I'm gonna go in a little bit more heavy dutily with the NYX Blush in Taupe on a smaller kind of brush. And then picking up Sketch and Espresso, no, Mystery, I always get the two confused. Mystery and Sketch on that same little brush. And I'm just gonna go over all of my face, so the cheekbones, the temples, and underneath the jawline, just to bring back that purple. And then I'm contouring my nose and under my lip just to even it all out. I'm not using any blush for this tutorial, but I am gonna highlight kinda like crazy with my MAC Memoir Skin Finish in Soft and Gentle. Then I'm going to use the Sports Girl Lip Crayon in Dark Angel, how appropriate, to kind of prep my lips before I'm using the Revlon Lipstick in Bubba Violet. So you could totally end the look here if you wanted something a little bit more not as dramatic, even though this is a rather dramatic look. But I love this, and you could totally keep it like this. But I wanted to do a little bit more hardcore, and I'm going to do that by adding in kind of like flicks or branches, or I don't even know what you would call this, but they extend from like that wing that I created with my liquid liner, and I'm using the Stila Smudge Pot in black for this on a Sigma E10 brush. I'm then going to add some glitter to the mix, because who doesn't love some glitter? And that was a Sports Girl glitter liner. It's like in a dark bluey black color. I'm then going to add some silver liner, just to kind of like the ends of those little flicks to make it kind of look like rhinestones. And there is both sides done, and this is the finished look. Nice and dramatic for our Dark Angel Halloween tutorial. And I'm going to take Mystery and Sketch on that same brush that I contoured my face with, and I'm going to kind of attempt to contour my collarbones and kind of my neck just to make me a little bit more gaunt. And I bought this costume from a really amazing website called costumebox.com.au. The costumes are extremely well made and the sizing is spot on. It comes with a whole bunch of accessories, so you don't have to buy anything extra. Everything that I'm wearing did come with it, and I love these little hand glove things. So that is the finished look. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up, and I'll see you next time.